and said that you had to experience paradise and hell to truly understand life. Well, I've had both right here, and I'm only 16. I'd planned not to turn 17 in this dump, but our brilliant state government decided dropouts shouldn't get to drive. I'm not going back to school, so it looks like I gotta wait till I'm 18 to pull out on the hillbilly highway and fly the hell out of paradise. Paradise. That's a laugh. Maybe when Lewis and Clark came through, before the companies took the trees so they could take the coal. Then a couple springs ago, with nothing left to stop the rain, the creeks filled and our homes washed away. The governor called it an act of God. When the things of life become temporary, you learn not to get attached. No one's left their government-bought mobile home. Wouldn't feel so bad about watching them wash downstream. This day would begin like every Saturday that I can remember, but it would end like no other. Clifford's been working on that car three times as long as it was ever on the road. People call him Wingnut behind his back. No one dare say it to his face. Marlon teaches English at our high school. It starts up again Monday. And I think he hates going back as much as the students. Not that he's bad at it. He's probably the best teacher there. I think he just loves being grown up and still having his summers off. He's supposed to be some kind of writer. But no one seemed interested enough to ask what he writes. He never seemed to mind not being asked.
Hey, Marlon. Getting any?
Making any progress?
I'll have her back on the road this summer.
Not much summer left. Didn't we have this discussion this same time last summer and the summer before?
You making fun of me?
I'm not making fun of you, Clifford.
But I thought it's time somebody told you that people are not driving souped-up Chevelles and Chargers anymore.
They're driving Toyotas and Subarus
and cars that get more than 5 miles a gallon last more than 5 years. You could have three of them for what you put in this sacred cow.
Goat! 1968 Pontiac GTO, 389, dual Holley carbs, hooker headers. Ever power shift one of these at 80? Power and beauty. Leave a mess in your pants if you're not careful. Them Japanese cars may be cheaper, but they ain't got no souls. Little suckers couldn't even reach the pedals on this baby.
Aw, Clipper said a bad word. Hey, Marlon, will you take me fishing? The creek's down. It's a real nice day.
Sorry, Skipper. Can't today.
I ain't got nobody to take me fishing, and Mom won't let me go along. I told her I could hear her calling if she wanted me. I wouldn't get in the water.
You stop bothering them, Skipper.
They say Evelyn was the happiest person you'd ever want to meet before Skipper was born. Her husband left not too long after they found out the boy wasn't right. She hasn't been the same since. Not that she's mean to the boy. They just sort of live in a 10-square-foot world that Evelyn rules through the screen door of her trailer.
Come on in and eat your breakfast.
No bother, Evelyn. Sorry I don't have time to take him.
No need to be sorry. The boy will live if you don't get to go fishing.
Why don't you just marry that gal? Better than keeping up two homes.
Well, that's a pretty good idea, except for that one little detail of her already being married.
That worthless Kendall. He ain't never coming back. You've been more of a daddy to them kids than he ever was.
What are you doing out and about so early?
Something happened, and I really don't understand it. But it's very important that we get everyone together tonight. God's coming, and he's going to grant us all a wish.
Nada, I didn't know you got religion.
I didn't know either. Why he picked me, I'll never know. God. God came to my trailer last night and gave me this message.
How do you know it wasn't a dream?
Oh, it was real. He's coming to paradise, Marlon. And we're going to get whatever we ask for.
That's really something, Nada.
Will you help me get everyone together tonight? They'll listen to you.
I was planning on taking Libby and the kids up to Charleston for the regatta.
Oh, I've known you since the day you were born, Marlon Dingus. In all that time, have I done you any favors?
Many times.
Then do me just one. You be here tonight. Our dreams will come true.
Who stopped by to see you, darling?
Well, good news, old boy. You've won another Pulitzer.
Congratulations, sweetheart.
Yay, Daddy!
I truly hate to mix business with pleasure, but if I am to continue to be a successful literary agent as you, a writer, I must.
Come along, children. Let's leave Daddy and Gerald to their business. We love you.
Now then, I know this new direction of meaningful literature has been rewarding for us both. But the publishers are begging for another of those delightful horror works. They've offered an astronomical advance.
Life is too short, Gerald. We must treat each work as if it's our last. When they dig through the rubble of the 20th century, do you want to be noted for some mindless exploitation? Or for something that at least tries to sculpt the joys as well as the sorrows of the human condition into meaningful matter? We've been through this before.
Yes, I know. But I do so love to hear you tell it.
Listen to the Lord's word. And the Lord's told us. It's blasphemy. Blasphemy. What gives you the authority to speak for the Almighty? He don't make appointments through ordinary humans. He don't sneak into old ladies' trailers for midnight discussions. When he has a message, the God I know speaks to all of us.
You just pissed because he didn't talk to you.
Nobody's talking to you, Clifford. The only spirits that speak to you is the demons of drugs and alcohol and illicit sex.
That ain't no demon, Avis. That's my old lady. At least she's got a church to preach in. The Church of Clifford. That smoking, drinking, humping son of a saint.
Listen to the Lord's word. And the Lord's told us. I want you to be hot.
When it comes to religion around here, there are just two kinds of people. Those who need it, and those who are eat up with it. Avis has it real bad. And like everyone I ever seen that got the calling, he was as wild as they came before the change. He always was a know-it-all, and now he had God to back him up.
You all don't have to believe me, but what's it gonna hurt for us to get together tonight? We haven't had a real party for, I can't remember when. Remember back before the flood? We all used to get together for any excuse we could find. We had singing and dancing and good food, good company. What's it gonna hurt for us to get together tonight? If I'm wrong, we have a good time. But if I'm right...
There ain't no right. There can't be no right in a world of wrong. Something's got into you, Nada. And it may feel good to you. But believe me, it's wrong. It just don't work this way. and what you want to me. But God ain't coming to paradise.
You better hope he does.
Look, he's here, he's here!
It's not God, it's the damn governor.
Gather around, everyone. The governor has selected your community for one of our road stop visits to personally explain our new deal for development.
Is that anything like your plan for progress? What was that other one?
Fighting for the future.
Well, now, we feel the deal for development is the right plan. Get West Virginia back on her feet. But it won't be easy. It's going to take all of us.
Is this a plan that's going to get me my job back?
Yeah. Our retraining program has been very successful. Very successful.
Free training for minimum wage. I made $17 an hour in the mines. How the hell am I supposed to pay my bills on minimum wage?
I know it's hard for you all to understand, but things are starting to get better now.
1/4 of our people live below the poverty line. We have the highest rate of unemployment, the biggest decrease in population in the country over the last decade. You call that making progress, Governor?
You a statistician or a reporter?
No, a teacher.
I should have known. Let's not forget the lowest teacher pay in the country. You know, you should listen to yourselves sometime. Like a bunch of whining grandmothers, you're quick to complain and pontificate, but not to come up with where the money for your raises will come from.
Well, that's your job.
Yeah, my job. Let me tell you about my job. You know that guy at the circus, balances spinning plates on sticks? That's me. As soon as I get one fixed, another starts to fall to the ground. It takes every bit of energy that I have to keep them all from crashing.
Hey, mister.
What's your problem?
I ain't got no problem, mister. I just want to go fishing.
Oh, that's nice. Pick on the retarded.
He's not retarded. He's slow.
Man has to leave the damn state to get work.
I'm so sick of hearing that. If that's how you want to deal with the problem, go ahead and leave. And we don't need you.
Go to hell.
Yeah, you go to hell.
What the governor meant to say was that...
Shut up. Get in the car. Any of you ever work out of state? Then why are you back? I'll tell you why. People aren't friendly. They make fun of the way you talk. You have to worry about getting mugged or you kids smoking crack. You make good money, but it ain't home. You want the truth? Maybe we are screwed. And you're not going to get your job back. They dig cleaner coal, twice as cheap in other countries. We're trying to get new industry into the area. We can't force them to come here. I'm sorry, I don't have the answers. One time I thought I did. Not now. Like it or not, we're in this together. We can go through it as friends or as enemies. I prefer friends.
We're having a little get-together tonight, Governor. You think you can make it?
You know, there's nothing I'd enjoy more, ma'am. But I need to be target practice for a few more communities before dark. But thanks for asking, anyway.
That is some good news for a change.
Bring a covered dish if you can. Say around 6.
I can't even remember his name. He's become like the invisible man, someone everyone tries not to see. I guess he could never accept not having work. Instead of blaming everything else like all the others, he blamed himself. Any man willing to work ought to be able to find work. He hadn't. He wore that sign around his neck like Jesus bore the cross.
Nita said God's coming to give us all a wish. Maybe he'll give you a job, Daddy.
She was famous. She's from up in Hedgesville.
Can we meet her? Can we get her autograph?
There's going to be 5,000 or 6,000 people crammed on that levee for that concert. We'll be lucky if we get close enough to see her. Now, what do y'all want from Gomart for the trip?
Mountain Dew.
Yoo-hoo and cheese nuts.
I got coupons for us, see?
I think it's such a special occasion, I could spring for the drinks of choice.
Thanks, Marlin. You're so nice.
It's easy to be nice to you. I'd give you kids every diamond in the sky if I could. But for now, it's going to be Yoo-hoos and Mountain Dews. And I'll be back in about 20 minutes, so let's be ready, okay?
Could you pick up something for me? Run and get my pocketbook.
I'll pay for it.
You just embarrassed to use food stamps. Afraid someone might think they're yours?
And I used to think you were funny.
It's not too late.
I told you 1,000 times, I ain't going back. It's a screwed up law. It ain't fair.
What's fair got to do with it? I agree it's wrong, but that's not going to get you a license. You know, you only have to be enrolled. Then at least you could drive till you turn 18. Hell, if you came once in a while, you'd probably get through. Many dumber than you have. Look at Clifford.
Don't make me have to use this on you.
Ladies?
Guess what's coming to paradise?
God. That's old news, Russell.
Better.
Better than God? Cable! There really is a God.
TBS, TNN, HBO, MTV.
The Playboy Channel?
Clifford, the Babel Belt is not something used to hold up your Sunday school pants.
I'll give you 20 bucks if you hook me up first.
Make it a free tune-up on my family cruising vessel.
Deal.
Done. See you Monday morning.
God bless us, everyone. I won't feel so bad about missing tonight's close encounter. I got my miracle.
You're not staying for the party?
Ain't gonna be no party. Crazy old lady.
I'm going to the Regatta. Kitty West is playing up there tonight. I met her one time, you know.
I slept with Madonna. She still sends me Christmas cards.
At the Votech Center, but I never actually went to college.
You have the honor, Susan, from questions submitted by our studio audience for 50 points. It is a fallacy that the people of Appalachia never travel. They do, once a year, known as the Hillbilly Riviera. For 50 points, where do they go?
Atlantic City.
No, I'm sorry. Dick?
The Smokies.
No, Dick. Wrong again.
Is it Myrtle Beach?
Why, yes. That's right.
I thought so. We used to stay at a really nice KOA there.
Back to you, Nada. Complete the popular Appalachian anecdote. Why did Saint Peter have to build a fence around heaven?
To keep West Virginians from sneaking home on weekends.
That's correct. With the game now up for grabs, the last question is back to you, Nada. Recite the most popular novelty license plate found on cars and trucks in Appalachia. Out of time. Aww. Susan?
Honk if you love Jesus.
Dick?
When guns are outlawed, only outlaws will have guns.
Last chance. Nada?
Eat more possum?
That's right. You're our winner. Come on down and take your chance at making your dreams come true. There are lovely and valuable prizes from the West Virginia Lottery behind each of these doors, but only one grand prize, made up of cash and prizes selected from your personal dream list. Now, is there anyone at home you'd like to say hello to?
Oh, I'd like to say hello to my grandson, Wesley, and his family, and all my friends at Paradise Park.
Okay, well, let's get to it. Nada. Which door will make your dreams come true?
Grandma, open the door.
Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Come on, Grandma, open the door. Nobody's gonna hurt you.
Nada made the mistake of inviting her family to the party. They think she's flipped. Want to take her to the doctor.
Come on, Grandma, open the door.
Just let him check you over, and if everything's okay, we'll bring you back tomorrow.
Tomorrow will be too late. I need to be here tonight.
Everything all right, Rick?
Hey, Marlon. She's probably just trying to get attention, but just in case, I thought we'd better get her checked out. Maybe keep her at the house a while.
I don't know. I talked to her this morning. Everything seemed all right.
Messages from God? Come on, Marlon, get real.
I'm not crazy. It really happened.
I didn't say you were. But it is crazy to think that any of these people are going to come to your God Watch party. They probably think you are crazy.
Are you going to her party? Tell her.
Why, sure. I'm fixing a three-bean salad. Yeah.
Ain't you?
Wouldn't miss it.
Shame on you for encouraging her.
Shame on me?
Whatever happened with us, Marlon? You were like my big brother.
You zigged? I zagged.
Get your things, Grandma. We're going.
Now, you just hold it right there, mister.
Butt out, cowboy.
I believe little lady said she didn't want to go. Now, why don't you just ride on out of here?
Don't do it.
Nothing wrong with zigging.
Nobody said there was.
It's the 90s, Marlon. Time to stop living in the past like a bunch of dumb hillbillies.
Hold it right there, Marlon. You said you were going to stay.
So did they. I had to, Nada. He was going to take you away.
What else do we have to do?
What do you say, Marlon? What the hell difference does it make what I say? Who am I, the Dalai Lama?
Why, you're the smart one, Marlon. Everybody says so. You don't expect us dumb hillbillies to make such a tough decision on our own, do you?
Since when did you ever not want to give your advice on a subject?
Come on, Marlon, don't screw it up.
I, the great and powerful...
And really smart.
And really smart, Marlon Dingus, do hereby proclaim tonight to be Paradise Park's Summer God Watch and Fun Fest.
Miss Nada, I just want you to know that you're not crazy. I got the message, too. I received transmission late last night, just like you did.
Well, thank you, cowboy. I feel much better now.
We get anything we want?
That's the way I heard it.
Crazies in paradise, Cowboy had the best excuse. He'd been in a bad wreck when he was younger and was never able to accept or understand his handicap. His theory was that the doctor put a communication device in his enema that now travels through his body sending and receiving messages. That's how he explains the voices.
Keeper, hun. You shouldn't feel responsible. She wouldn't live here even if we'd let her. I know you don't want to think about this, but there are nice places for people like her.
Who are people like her?
Old ladies who get special instructions from God.
And besides the hefty purse that's involved in winning the Shoney's PGA Classic, there's much more at stake for this young club pro, wouldn't you say?
Oh, I should say so. Wesley has been waiting for a putt like this his entire life. Miss it, and he stays where he is. Make it, and he transcends his inertial existence, giving him a first-class ticket to the first world, while escaping the prohibitive heritage that has kept him down so long.
Thank you.
Gilmore and get me a pack of cigarettes, will you?
I'm gonna get ready for the party.
I ain't going to that stupid party.
The hell you aren't. The first possibility of a good time in this dump, we're not gonna miss it.
I'm convinced that Ramona was put on this planet to serve as my sexual fantasy. She parties every night and sleeps till noon every day. I'd heard she was an exotic dancer up in St. Albans for a while. Maybe she'll pork up and grow a mustache like the others when she gets older. But for now, Ramona was a goddess. I suppose Clifford was the closest she could find to her have fun and don't give a damn about nothing philosophy. They seemed perfect for each other.
See your hooters if you go get my cigarettes.
What'd you say?
Well, honey, I was gonna have him get you a pack, too.
Come on in and change your oil, Clifford. Maybe people will talk to you tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
Marlboro Light.
Yes, a bell. Hey, you little creep. I see you sneaking by. You're gonna pay for my window.
Hey, Clifford. Hey, Clifford. You're not wrong here, honey, are you? Are you, Clifford?
No.
Don't you scare that boy.
Come on down here, Evelyn. Let me give you a big wet one on the lips.
I'd rather swim and piss.
Oh, Mommy said a bad word.
Ever get those dark marks on your nose from pressing too close to the screen?
Mind your business, Clifford.
Do you really think God's gonna come and give us all a wish?
I don't think so. Life's just not that easy.
Why are you sad, Mommy?
I'm okay.
Why don't you sing a song like you do when we're sad?
I don't feel much like singing.
It's a new morning, a new morning. Yesterday's gone, tomorrow's far away. It's a new morning, a new morning. I think it just might be our day.
Beer? Day. You
read all these?
Uh-huh. You like guacamole?
I don't know. What's it taste like?
Just like chicken. Only different.
So you're a writer?
It depends. You mean the kind that publishes? No. You mean the kind that collects dust? Yeah.
Just like chicken.
Thought you'd like it.
Isn't it hard to publish books without endings?
You know, maybe that is why. You got your big request ready for this evening?
The God Watch? Well, I suppose I can narrow it down to just one if I have to.
And?
First tell me why you don't finish your books. Then I'll tell you my wish.
I thought we were having one of those ask no questions and tell no lies kind of relationships.
Sorry.
I'm not sure, really. Sometimes I think I get to like the characters too much. When it comes time to write the end, I don't want to leave them. I keep telling myself, if you'll just put it down for a while and come back later, you'll be able to finish it. But I never have.
Well, I'm sure you will.
I showed you mine, now you show me yours.
Never-ending romance. With someone who'll never fall out of love with me. No matter what I do. Can you give me that?
I don't know. I could try, I guess.
Don't worry, sweet prince. It's impossible. Bad it can't be like a Hollywood musical. Sing a song, dance a dance. Problems all go away. Everybody stays in love.
I'm afraid I'm not much of a singer.
You make up for it in other ways.
Sex is taught in other parts of the world, but in West Virginia, all boys learn the same way, hunting camp. When you were finally old enough for that once-a-year outing, you found that there was more in store than freezing in the woods, hoping for a 12-pointer to walk by. The great thing about hunting camp sex education was no one had to explain a thing. There were all the visual aids you would ever need, dirty paperbacks for the literary types, hundreds of exotic magazines, and best of all, 8mm movies. The first time I saw one, I thought it was wrestling. I embarrassed my dad when I yelled out, "Who's winning?" Still, better than him having to explain it, I guess.
more than five people together and the tales of yesteryear pour like the spring rain. Funny thing is, none of the days I ever heard them talk about sounded too good. Surviving cruel seasons, the coal wars, revenuers. God damn if I'd want to remember that. My grandpa told me that we have to remember the past. Well, I don't want to cane shares or hunt sang, and I sure as hell don't plan to dig no coal. The only thing I want to remember is how much I want to forget when I get out of here.
There's been some bad ones out there, and I've seen too many of them.
You decide to go back to school yet?
And education's the one thing the man can't take away from you, boy.
We didn't have a choice. When I was your age, I worked in the mines 12 hours a day picking slate.
Now he just picks his butt.
I don't think you're going to get the blue ribbon.
I expect anybody to eat something that looks like snot.
She who was without crazy idea cast the first stone. Yeah, and I just heard on the news that this all got headed this way on weather radar.
You'd better get them wishes ready, then. Give him a break. He's a little mixed up.
A little?
sorry.
No, it's okay. It was nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you.
Oh, bull. He's just a power play. Stevie could play circles around him any day. Hey, Marlon, what do you think? Who's a better guitar player, Eddie Van Halen or Stevie Ray Vaughan?
Who?
Thanks a lot, Marlon. You can go back in your cave now.
Uh-oh. Here's $22. I'll give you the rest later. I'm sorry I broke your window, Clifford. Sometimes I just get caught up in it and get carried away. Come on.
It's a miracle! Well, I haven't been able to use that hand since I got it stuck in that old Buick transmission 13 years ago. You healed me, Avis!
It ain't right to make fun of religion.
Well, I'm not making fun, Avis. We're all religious in our own way. Why, Ramona here's a regular practitioner of snake handling. Ain't you, honey?
And after you find the property, you buy it, no money down. And then you turn around and sell it for a profit before you had to make a single payment. You make money without spending a cent. It's foolproof.
You can sure be the judge of that.
If it's so damn easy, how come more people ain't doing it?
Mr. Duverack says most people are afraid to take the initiative. Most are happy to stay right where they are. But there's a special breed of those who have to reach further. Take the risk, but reap the rewards.
I suppose you're one of those.
Until then, did I realize?
Strange things to a man. My Frank probably would have lived another 10 years if he hadn't been laid off. Work was the only thing he ever knew. Going into that welfare office did terrible things to him. We stopped buying birthday presents for one another. We didn't even go out to eat anymore on our anniversary. Then we stopped talking. I don't think he ever really stopped loving me. But he just didn't feel like a man anymore. You're young, Libby. You've got 2 or 3 more lives ahead of you. Them kids will be raised before you know it. And then you'll start a new chapter.
Say you are able to find this land that nobody else can find. And say you can get it for no money down. What happens if you can't sell it?
I don't know yet.
You don't know?
I just applied to the program. You have to send in an essay of your own ideas for financial independence. I think mine were pretty good. If you get accepted, you get a study program.
Yeah, along with a bill.
Your man's a damn millionaire, and he didn't have nothing to start with. You can't argue with that. Johnny?
Well, let me get this now. You think just because you ran away, you don't have to pay your bills? I told him you'd be back just a matter of time if you screwed up whatever you were doing.
I'll get the money.
You should have thought of that 6 months ago.
Come on, Johnny. How am I supposed to work without my truck?
You work? Ha! That's an original idea, Kendall. Kendall, get out front of there. I swear to God, I'll have him run right over you.
Please don't kill my dad.
Go ahead. I ain't worth a damn without my truck.
You ain't worth a damn anyway, Kendall.
You couldn't be more wrong, my dear man.
are Kendall Laymaster of Paradise Park, are you not?
Yes, sir.
Come on out of there, Kendall. I've got something to tell you.
What's going on here, Kendall?
They came to tow my truck, Mr. Durack.
This man's a deadbeat.
This man's a financial genius. I receive hundreds of applications for the Wallace C. Dubarak Home Prosperity Study Course every day. When my associates read Mr. Laymaster's essay, his ideas were so bright and so innovative that they brought his application directly to me.
You like my ideas?
Like them? Your plan to leverage VA multi-unit equity properties at unadvertised government auctions is making us millions. As we speak. Your commission, Kendall. The first of many.
See? I told y'all.
Sorry, Kendall.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
And you know what the best part is? We did it with no money down.
Say it!
What's your truck, sir?
Tell him, Kendall.
Up your big fat
stop bothering me a long time ago. Scab! Company suck pig! You understand one thing, you mess up and your ass is grass. There ain't nobody out here gonna give a damn.
There's no way to treat your own.
You stopped being my own a long time ago. I played by the rules. They took care of me. Living in this government trailer park makes no sense. Going on strike year after year, that's union bullshit! Where's your goddamn union now? You ain't my own.
Now?
No, but I'll take you for a hot dog.
You bring him right back.
Why don't you join us, Evelyn? We've got a special tonight. All you can eat, your free wish.
No, thanks. I already ate. Don't you let Clifford give him any beer.
I love you too, Mommy.
Marlon got me a hot dog.
Well, I'll be damned if it was my fault. I gave my life to that company. They made us think it'd last forever.
Hell, they had to blame someone to get away with just picking up and pulling out without putting a cent back into the area.
Yeah, except what they gave the politicians.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be just our luck? They find out the one natural resource we have burns a hole in the sky.
Ah, hey, but let God fix it for us. Let's wish for low sulfur coal. Hell, make it no sulfur coal.
How about it, Nada? You think you'll go for that?
I don't know why not.
Have you received any updates, cowboy?
Constipation's been blocking his transmissions.
You're all going to feel pretty silly if he does come. But I think I'll go and see if I can get Evelyn to come out.
Maybe we ought to have a wish, just in case.
You all don't seem to understand. If he does come, there'll be no wishes this world. You best be thinking about the next.
For God's sake, Avis, will you cheer up? Religion don't have to be screaming and yelling and being mad all the time.
Straight from the book of the Prophet Clifford. You want anything?
What are you gonna wish for?
I don't believe in it.
What do you believe in?
Nothing. That way I'm never disappointed.
Be careful what you wish for.
Thank you.
stay for her own party.
I think she's the only reason we did this.
She didn't even try and resist.
Well, how could she?
No, we didn't try to help her either. We should have stopped them.
Well, there was nothing we could do.
It's God's will. Shut the hell up, Avis.
Don't blame this on God. If you have to blame somebody besides us, blame John Kennedy or Lyndon Johnson.
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about the goddamn Great Society. That's what I'm talking about. They came in here, bought us shoes, gave us food stamps so we'd have something to eat. Gave us these beautiful trailers when our houses washed away. We'd never be poor again. They gave. Yeah, they gave all right. But it was give and take. They took our pride. They took our will. We used to be known for our independence, our self-reliance. Now look at us. Can't even hold on to our own vehicles. I hate to be the one to break this to you people, but the war on poverty was lost. And we're the refugees.
What are you doing, Clifford? I'm gonna go get her. Any of you sissies wanna help? Come on, big mouth. You're quick to point out how screwed up we are. Do something about it.
Thank you.
get home, Skipper. Your mama's gonna whip your butt.
What time is it?
It's, 5 after 12.
Oh, I'm so ashamed.
It's all right. We had a good time.
It was the best party we've had in years.
You never did believe me, did you?
I believed you, Native.
We believed that you believed.
Maybe I am crazy.
Well, if you are, you're in good company.
God, why did you do this? Why did you make me look foolish in front of my friends? I did what you asked.
Come on, Nada. It's all right.
We deserve a wish. We're good people. We never did no harm to no one. You promised us a wish.
Fairy tale world. This is real. You can't get away from it.
You don't know about real. Well, relationships with characters move around on a piece of paper. They always like you. Think you're the coolest. You'll never fall out of love with you. And you can't end the stories because you can't get better. Don't tell me about real.
Handouts. Just let us take care of our own.
someone who had a hard time with endings, Marlon got a crash course on him. Two in one day. I'm not sure if God really came to paradise or not, but we all got what we wished for that night. Things seemed a little better after that. Of course, it won't make much difference to me. As soon as I graduate, I'm pulling out onto the hillbilly highway and flying the hell out of paradise. One thing I will always remember was Marlon's response when folks were complaining about the outside forces that kept us down. He'd say that those who push the buttons will someday need us more than we need them. The meek shall inherit the earth, so they better get to know us.